Hi guys, today video is how to simulate pulse amplitude modulation PAM in LabVIEW. After the current video session, you will be able to understand principles of amplitude modulation and demodulation. Pulse width modulation may be used to transmit analog information such as continuous speech or data. It is a system in which continuous waveforms are sampled at regular intervals. Information regarding the signal is transmitted only at the sampling time, together with any synchronizing pulse that may be required at the receiving end. Pulse amplitude modulation. The simplest form of modulation, it form an excellent introduction to pulse modulation in general. Pulse PAM is pulse modulation system is in which the signal is sampled at regular intervals and each sample is made proportion to the amplitude of the signal at instant of sampling. So input signal to the multiplier or AND gate, and then sampling signal second input of AND gate, and then we filter PAMs from low pass filter, and then we receive our waveform. Now we are going to our LabVIEW. So here now we are in LabVIEW front panel and block diagram. Here in front panel, please right click and go to numeric control. Here one numeric control, numeric two, numeric control, numeric two, numeric control, right click, numeric to numeric control. Here we place four numeric buttons. Now we are at block diagram. So first numeric and second numeric, third and fourth. Right click, view as icon, right click, view as icon, right click, view as icon, right click, view as icon. We place the simulate signal function in virtual instrument at block diagram by right clicking express to signal analysis to simulate signal. Here one simulate signal. So first we put here is a sine signal and frequency of 100 hertz, amplitude 1, offset 0, signal name is sine, and press OK button. Right click, view as icon, and we can change the name of as sine signal. Then we put an other simulate signal function, right click here, express to signal analysis to simulate signal. Here we put another, so this is signal is square and 10 hertz frequency, offset of 1, amplitude 1, 50% duty cycle, and press OK. So view as icon, name as square signal. Then we rename our values as amplitude then third is frequency 2 so its rename is amplitude 2 okay now we bring a multiplier numeric to multiply here we put a multiplier then we bring filter but we right click at block diagram expresses to signal analysis to filters so here we put a filter so here we make a low pass filter cutoff frequency is 10 hertz out of 3 topology network signals and then press okay now here right click and numeric to adder and one adder here and right click to numeric to number constant here we make 15 so now we wired all the blocks at block diagrams so frequency here sine signal frequency now you can see there are frequencies so we can wired frequency here so amplitude terminal and amplitude terminal then second frequency terminal to second no now do it again second frequency terminal to frequency terminal second amplitude terminal to second amplitude terminal so here plus is with first frequency terminal and we make 15 offset plus and then output of this plus to lower cutoff of filter then we put output of first signal sine wave to input of first multiplier and output of second square signal to input of second input of multiplier then output of multiplier to for low pass filter here our input of filter signal and now we insert all diagram into while loop filter by right clicking here express access control while loop with buttons here we put all our amplitude modulation block diagram into the while loop and then here right click expresses to exceed control we put time delay here so we put the time delay of 0.500 seconds okay view as icon so now we put some output graphs stop button here. So we comes to the front panel by right clicking graph to waveform graph. First waveform graph to waveform graph, second waveform graph to waveform graph, third waveform graph to curve waveform graph, and fourth it. So we can arrange them. So first is here, second is here, third is here, and fourth is here. So we put filter signal into fourth waveform graph, right click view as icon, and name as demodulated signal. Okay, demodulated signal. Then we put third graph this into this and name as carrier pulse . So we put his name is carrier pulse signal. So we put carrier pulse signal here and view as icon. So then we make this waveform graph to output of multiplier as multiplier as pulse modulated signal, pulse modulated signal, and view as icon. Put first input of waveform graph to the our sine signal. So this we put his name is message signal. So we put here is message signal and view as icon. So now this is our block diagram for pulse amplitude modulation, and its front panel is here, message signal, pulse modulated signal, carrier pulse signal, and demodulated signal. Here frequency of sine wave is 0, so we put here is 11 hertz and amplitude is 1. Frequency of carrier pulse signal as square wave is we put 100 and amplitude is 1. So now we run, so you can see here is our amplitude of message signal, sine is 1, and here is our pulse modulated signal and carrier pulse signal. Is this is square wave and this is our modulated signal and this is our demodulated signal, you can see. And for stop here we can stop by pressing the stop button. Now we can run again by clicking the run button, and we could change amplitude and frequency as we can. So we can change the frequency up to 30. You can notice as the frequency is increasing, the cycles are more and the pulse modulator signals are changed and the demodulator signal is as well as change. So as we can increase the modulation amplitude, you can see the changes bring here and here. So we here put 1 again and we decrease the frequency of our message signal. Decrease the frequency, you can see the changes in our. Now we can change frequency of our carrier pulse signal as well. So by changing the frequency of our carrier pulse, you can notice the more edges in pulse modulated signal. And now we change the amplitude and we see the variations in our signals. So you can notice how we can get pulse amplitude modulation and control its carrier and message signal frequency and amplitude. So if you like my video, please subscribe my channel and hit like button. Thank you very much.